Hello, my name is Faisal Khan. I'm doing a series of videos on Ripple and Stellar and all the other networks that are basically going to be moving crypto and fiat and have these currency pairs, and I will be able to bridge and move money across borders. And I'm addressing some of the difficult points or the hurdles that they will be facing. And one of the biggest hurdles is access to banking. There are many, many players around the world who are licensed or are quasi-licensed, i.e. they are sponsored by the licensing institution, or maybe they have a license themselves, or maybe they are RA, a registered agent, authorized delegate, an EMD, electronic money distributor, nomenclature notwithstanding of their designation, but you know, they are licensed, but yet they cannot find access to banking. Why? In the traditional sense, and quite a few money transmitter license holders themselves who want to enter into this business are finding that the original banks that they work with, the JP Morgan, the Wells Fargo, the Bank of America, etc., and you know, they can be big or small, are saying, no, you know what, we approved you originally only for fiat. We do not want to see you do crypto. You touch crypto, access to banking from our side is taken out. Now, you may say, okay, fine, you know what? You don't do the crypto part of business with Bank of America, for example, or with Wells Fargo, for example. But guess what? Turns out there's a lot of arm twisting being involved. The bank auditor is coming in and saying, ah, Mr. Khan, you are not doing the crypto business with our bank, and that's fine because we forbid you for it, but you're doing it with Bank ABC or Bank XYZ. And guess what? That's not acceptable to us. Because of that, we will take the banking privileges and access to banking that we have given you in Bank of America or Wells Fargo away from you. That is the level of arm twisting and blackmailing, if you will, that is going on in the industry. Banks are saying, no, we are happy with you just staying focused on fiat. You touch crypto, you lose your existing banking. In many cases, and you know, where sanity prevails, they say, okay, you know what? Do whatever, but you are not going to do it with our banking. You're not going to do it with our funds. You're not going to do it through our network, our processing, our processors, etc. You do everything and keep it segregated. So in this case, you know, some community banks are willing to work with, you know, the crypto elements, the crypto side of business. So they are willing to provide them with ACH. They are willing to provide them with card processing services and everything else. So they're completely segregated business. But most businesses cannot find crypto-friendly banking for cross-border because that's a huge issue. So when you have liquidity providers or these originators or the terminators in these countries who would like to work with Ripple, who would like to work with Stellar, who would like to bring some stablecoin or work with some exchanges and move BTC or ETH, you know, across the border, access to banking is a huge issue. If you are one such company and you are facing access to banking, get in touch with us. We may be able to help you. There's a contact form in the description below. There's also a WhatsApp. You know, give us a shout and let's see what we can do. But don't take it lightly. Access to banking is pretty much, I mean, there are many other factors preventing the rapid scale and growth of crypto in the cross-border sector, but this is a huge, huge issue. I have a few friends in Ripple, I have a few friends in Stellar, I have a few friends in Corda, I have a few friends who are using other technologies and stable coins to do this thing. And I keep saying it, it's a risky moot point, you know, for us, and we always sort of stop and say, you know what, fuck man, we don't have access to banking. You know, shit man, we don't have access to banking. I wish I could find access to banking in a way that we feel is fair. Because remember, banks who enter this business are not charging a flat fee. They too are introducing the 20 basis points. So if bank is charging 20 basis points, your liquidity provider is going to charge 20 basis points. The transaction is 40 basis points heavy at the start of get-go. On the offload side, it might be 30 basis points. You're paying 70 basis points for a transaction that will move in seconds versus, let's say, 10 basis points for a transaction that will move in an hour with a pre-funded account. So what's the difference, you know? So access to banking is something that seriously needs to be looked at, and it is a serious hurdle and a problem in the industry. Like I said, if you have this issue, get in touch with us. And, you know, tell us what you think of this video in the comment section below. Till next time, this is Faisal Khan, signing off.